Waalaikumsalam. Ini suaranya dengar nggak ya? Saya mau tes suara dulu. Oh, dengar. Alhamdulillah. Jelas atau putus-putus ya? Oke. Kita tunggu yang lainnya ya. Bentar ya, saya mau gabungin kelas A sama kelas B. Waalaikumsalam. Yang lain bisa dengar suara saya? Oke. Kita tunggu teman-teman yang lain ya, bentar lagi. Bentar lagi kita mulai. Iya, itu buku elektroniknya yang PDF-nya halaman. Bentar ya. Halaman 58. Biasanya sama Miss Eli, mulainya sampai teman-teman berapa orang ya jumlahnya? Kalau 5 orang sudah bisa dimulai. Waalaikumsalam, Ciput. Kayaknya udah bisa kita mulai nih ya. Kita mulai sekarang aja, oke? Oke. Nah, so I am your new teacher because Miss Ellie cannot teach you right now because she is so busy. Jadi saya ini penggantinya Miss Ellie karena Miss Ellie itu lagi sibuk, lagi banyak job. And then I am talk to her and she talk to me that we are going to learn English by chapter 3. Kita mulai belajar bahasa Inggrisnya dari chapter 3 karena you have learned chapter 1 and chapter 2 before with Miss Ellie, right? So, as we know that we learn 4 skills in each chapter, for example, listening, speaking, reading, and writing. And now I'm going to teach you about the speaking part in chapter 3. Karena biasanya kita kan belajar 4 skill ya di masing-masing chapter. Ada namanya listening, speaking, reading, sama writing. Nah, sekarang kita bahas tentang yang speaking. And you can open your page, open your book page 58, if I'm not mistaken. Yep, 58. Bukunya halaman 58. Okay, so I want one of you read activity 1. Just read the bubble. Can you see the bubble? Bisa dilihat bubble-bubblenya itu kan yang perkataan-perkataannya itu. Would you like to come over for dinner Saturday night? Nah, I want one of you read this bubble. Okay, please somebody who wants to read. Ayo, siapa yang mau baca? Yang bubble-bubblenya itu yang activity satunya. Nobody? Oke, rasa akhirnya. Tunggu ya, saya aktifkan dulu mic-nya. Aduh. Tia, Lia. Karena rasa duluan yang giliran bacanya ya. Sebentar ya, ini dia lagi loading mic-nya. Halo Rosa. Okay, good evening. I'm good, thank you. How are you? Okay, you can start now. Yes, exactly. Okay. Yep, activity 1. Okay. Okay. Please come over. Pardon? Yeah. No. Yeah, that is the question that you just read. Just read without any answer. Both of them. Yep. Oke, good job, Rasa. Thank you. Saya matikan ya mic-nya ya. Okay, thank you, Rasa. So your friend Rasa has read about this question and the sentence from activity 1. Jadi teman kalian Rasa sudah membaca tadi. Nah, Rasa asked me just now whether she should read the question or the answer or both. But actually, this is not the question and this is not the answer. They are different each other. Jadi kan tadi Rasa nanya, ini saya baca pertanyaannya aja atau juga jawabannya. Nah, ini dia dua-dua yang beda. Pertanyaannya beda, jawabannya beda. Ini bukan pertanyaan jawaban. Ini dia ada masing-masing kalimatnya. Okay, we can see the first sentence. Would you like to come over for dinner Saturday night? Ada yang bisa artiin untuk Miss? Tolong. Would you like to come over for dinner Saturday night? You can type the Indonesian of this sentence by chat without speak to me. Come on, somebody please. I'm waiting. Tik tok. Ayo. I'll give you a bonus every time you answer my question or every time you want to read the sentence like Miss Ellie usually did to you. Nobody? Tidak ada yang bisa? Ini typingnya banyak sekali nih. Saya jadi bingung. Ini memang mau jawab pertanyaan? Atau bagaimana ini? Would you like to come over for dinner Saturday night? What is the meaning? Apa artinya itu dalam bahasa Indonesia? Ayo, ayo, ayo. This is the really simple question. Okay. Aduh, sepertinya saya ini yang salah. Saya tidak melihat ke bawah tulisannya. Okay. Yang pertama menjawab adalah Rasa lagi. Okay, Rasa, maukah Anda datang untuk makan malam di Sabtu malam? Kemudian ada Aduh, saya yang salah nih, maaf ya. Saya tadi tidak melihat ke bawah. Ada Dizua, bisakah kamu datang untuk makan malam-malam ini? Malam ini atau Sabtu malam? Saturday night, ya kan? Oh, ayo. Kemudian, nah, diperbaiki ternyata. Oke, good job. Terus ada Tia. Maukah Anda datang untuk makan malam Sabtu malam? Ada Ciput. Maukah kamu datang untuk makan malam Sabtu malam Minggu? Sabtu malam Minggu, double ya artinya. Darsim Meliasan, suaranya putus-putus, Miss. Oh, suaranya putus-putus. Oh, sekedar pemberitahuan, ini kelasnya gabungan ya, antara kelas A sama kelas B. Jadi kalau misalnya ada yang nggak kenal, itu berarti tetangga sebelah. Oke, Dizwa, oke. Sukamti, apakah kamu bisa datang untuk pergi makan malam Sabtu malam? Lia, akan Anda suka datang untuk makan malam Sabtu malam? Oke, nah, jadi berhubung rasa tadi yang jawab pertama kali berarti rasa yang dapat bonusnya. Yeay! Oke, jadi artinya udah tahu semua ya. Apakah kamu bisa datang untuk makan malam pada Sabtu malam? Nah, pertanyaan, maksud saya pernyataan seperti ini merupakan jenis kalimat yang disebut invitation. This kind of sentence, we can call it as invitation. So, this chapter 3, on speaking part, we will learn how to invite someone, how to invite somebody to a party, to a dinner, to a wedding, and to many celebration that we hold. Kita akan membahas tentang bagaimana cara mengundang seseorang, baik itu ke pesta, ke tempat ulang tahun, ke makan malam, atau perayaan-perayaan lainnya di bagian speaking ini. Oke, okay, and then we continue to the second sentence. Tadi yang pertama itu udah jelas ya mengenai invitation. Oke, okay, yang kedua. Hey, we're having a party on Friday. Can't you come? Oke, okay, again. What is the meaning? Come on. Jangan sampai rasa lagi yang dapat rasa nanti dapat double bonus dia. Ayo, selamat malam semua. Ayo, ayo, siapa cepat dia yang dapat? Hey, we're having a party on Friday. Can you come? This is not, I'm not asking you about the kind of sentence, I'm asking you about the meaning of this sentence. Okay, Lia, hey, kami mengadakan pesta hari Jumat, kamu bisa datang? Good job, pinter sekali. Ya, Dizua terlambat dia, okay, gak apa-apa ya, masih ada banyak kesempatan ini. Okay, so, hey, we're having a party on Friday, can you come? Like Lia type before, she said that, hey, kami mengadakan pesta hari Jumat, kamu bisa datang? This is also a kind of sentence. So, these two sentences are the kind of invitation, how to invite someone to a celebration. Nah, dua kalimat yang pertama ini tadi adalah cara-cara bagaimana kita mengundang seseorang ke suatu perayaan. Nah, yang ketiga ini dia agak sedikit beda nih. Agak sedikit beda dan bukan arti dari invitation. Ayo, cepat-cepat ya. I'll be there on time. Just wait for me. What is the meaning? Aduh, dijual kok lemot-lemot. Okay, let's see who is first. Rasa, saya akan di sana tepat waktu. Tunggu saya. Okay, dua, tiga. Profi, benar, cuman kurang cepat ya. Okay. Jadi artinya, I'll be there on time, just wait for me. Saya akan datang ke sana tepat waktu. Tunggu aja, oke? Nah, as I said before, this two sentence before is a kind of invitation. But the third one, I'll be there on time ini, this is the different kind of sentence. What kind of sentence, Miss? Nah, jenis kalimat ini adalah sebuah kalimat menyatakan pernyataan. A sentence contains a statement. This is not a question, not an invitation, just a statement that the person wants to tell the inviter. Nah, kalau yang dua kalimat pertama ini kan diucapkan oleh yang undang, kan? Nah, kalau yang kalimat ketiga ini diucapkan oleh yang diundang. Itu perbedaannya. Oke? Okay? Nah, if you feel that I'm teaching you too fast, or do you have any question in the middle of my sentence, just ask, just type, ya. Kalau misalnya kalian merasa saya agak terlalu cepat atau ada pertanyaan, tolong di chat aja ya, tolong diberitahu aja. Oke, okay, we continue to sentence number 4. Please come over for a drink sometime. What is the meaning? Come on, again, somebody, anybody, please. Oke, Dizua, aku harap kamu mau datang minum lain waktu. Bisa, agak kurang tepat, tapi dimengerti. Silakan dari rasa, silakan datang untuk minum kalau ada waktu. Ya, ini lebih tepat artinya, tapi karena Dizua dia telah, because you have an effort to type fast, then I will give the bonus to Dizua, okay? Wait a minute, I'm writing your name. Bentar ya, saya tulis dulu ya. Okay, benar teman-teman. Please come over for a drink sometime. Jadi Miss, kalau tadi kurang tepat arti dari Dizua, artinya tepat apa Miss? Please come over for a drink sometime. Kalau ada waktu, kapan-kapan, bolehlah mampir untuk minum-minum. Itu dia. Sebenarnya Betty beda-beda tipis, tapi bisa dimengerti, oke? Okay? Nah, so Miss, is this a sentence of a kind of an invitation or just a statement? What do you think? Is this an invitation or a statement? Please come over for a drink sometime. Ini undangan atau pertanyaan atau jawaban atau cuman apa ini? Ayo. Please come over for a drink sometime. Is this an invitation, a question, an answer, a statement, or what? Go, 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 go. Rasa, invitation. Very good. Benar sekali. Ini jenis dari invitation. Karena apa? Karena dia mengundang seseorang untuk datang minum kapan-kapan. Ini Lia kenapa jadi ke yang lain ya? Okay, so would you like to come over for dinner Saturday night? Hey, we're having a party on Friday. Can you come? Please come over for a drink sometime. So these three sentences are a type of invitation. Meanwhile, I'll be there on time, just wait for me, is a statement. Okay, we continue to sentence number 5. Why don't you come over and see us sometime soon? Why don't you come over and see us sometime soon? Nah, this time I want you to give me the meaning of the sentence and also the kind. Remember? Okay. The meaning and the kind of the sentence. artinya dan juga jenis kalimatnya. Teman di luar, kenapa kamu tidak mau datang dan melihat kita suatu saat nanti? Ayo tadi Miss minta apa? Pertanyaan statement? Kok pertanyaan statement? Pernyataan? Bahasa Inggrisnya apa? Question. Statement bahasa Inggrisnya apa? Pernyataan. Jadi kenapa pertanyaan statement? Jawaban yang betul apa? Ayo coba. Yang baru gabung langsung buka halaman 58 ya. Open your book page 58. Tidak punya buku ya? Aduh. Nah, di layar nampak kok, kata Sitiya. Tadi si Dizua sudah membuat artinya. Kenapa kamu tidak mau datang dan melihat kita suatu saat nanti? Kenapa kamu tidak mau datang dan melihat kita suatu saat nanti? Jenis kalimatnya apa nih, Dizua ini? Pernyataan, bukan pertanyaan ya. This is a kind of statement, not a question. Oh, misalnya salah ternyata. Why don't you come over and see us sometime soon? This is an invitation. Nah, tadi yang Dizua sudah tuliskan artinya. Kenapa kamu tidak mau datang dan melihat kita suatu saat nanti? Agak sedikit melenceng dia artinya sebenarnya. Why don't you come over and see us sometime soon? Artinya datanglah kapan-kapan lihat kami. Datanglah kapan-kapan dan lihat kami sesegera mungkin. Nah, itu dia artinya. Kalau dia kenapa kamu tidak mau datang? Itu tidak dalam konteks yang ini. Jadi beda dia artinya. Oke. Tadi siapa yang bisa jawab? Dizua dia cepat, cuman dia agak kamu agak tidak tepat artinya. Invitation bukan statement ya. Oke, dan karena tidak ada lagi yang menjawab, maka saya akan berikan bonusnya setengah tadi dua. Oke, so this kind of sentence, why don't you come over and see us sometime soon? It is also an invitation. Let me make it clear. There is a difference between question and invitation. Karena tadi dia, teman kalian agak bingung dia, question atau invitation. Nah, if you want to make an invitation sentence, this is the kind of example. Why don't you come over and see us sometime soon? Hey, we're having a party on Friday, can't you come? But if you want to make a question, the example like this. What is the time now? Or what is your name? How are you? It is a question, but this type of sentence, it is called invitation. Okay? And then, the last sentence. sometimes this is your last change. You have to be really fast. What about tomorrow night? I'll be free at that time. What about tomorrow tonight? I'll be free at that time. What is the meaning? And what is the... Iya, nggak apa-apa. What is the meaning and also what is the kind of sentence? What about tomorrow tonight? I'll be free at that time. What about tomorrow tonight? I'll be free at that time. Bagaimana dengan besok malam? Aku ada waktu senggang di waktu itu. Jawaban atas undangan. Wah! Pinter sekali nih. Senang saya mengajar teman-teman kalau seperti ini semua. Bagaimana dengan besok malam? Aku ada waktu senggang di waktu itu. Jawaban atas undangan. Betul sekali. Ini ada rasa juga ini. Tapi agak kurang cepat ya. Ada wiwing juga. Ya. Sepertinya si Bijua ini betul-betul mengumpulkan poin malam ini. Dua yang saya minta betul semuanya. What about tomorrow tonight? Ini kayaknya salah nih sentence-nya. What about tomorrow tonight? Bagaimana dengan besok malam ini? Ini seharusnya night. What about tomorrow night? Bagaimana dengan besok malam? Gak ada to-nya ya. What about tomorrow night? I'll be free at that time. Bagaimana dengan besok malam? Aku kosong kok waktu itu. Nah, this is the answer of the invitation. Seperti teman kalian jawab itu. Itu jawaban atas undangan. Alright, so I want to conclude. Saya mau menyimpulkan. From these six sentences, there are two types of sentence. Only for this part. Ada jenis-jenis kalimat, tapi cuman di chapter ini aja. Di chapter yang lainnya masih banyak lagi jenis-jenis kalimat. What are they? They are first invitation, and then the second is the statement. Or we can call as the answer of the invitation. Jadi, di speaking part ini ada dua jenis kalimatnya. Ada invitation, ada undangan, dan ada answer-nya, ada jawaban dari undangan tersebut. The example of invitation, first, would you like to come over for dinner Saturday night? Hey, we're having a party on Friday, can you come? Why don't you come over and see us sometime soon? And then, the answer of the invitation or the statement. First, I'll be there on time, just wait for me. Second, please come over for a drink sometime. And the last, what about tomorrow night? I'll be free at that time. Okay. So, I hope you understand what is invitation and how to answer this invitation. But, okay, Sukamti. But this is only a few example of invitation and the answer. Ini cuman sedikit jumlah contohnya, ya. Dari jenis-jenis undangan dan dari jawabannya. Later, in the next page, di halaman-halaman berikutnya, we will learn a lot, really a lot. Kita akan belajar banyak, banyak betul, about how to make a sentence to invite or to answer someone to a celebration. Nanti di halaman-halaman berikutnya itu ada banyak sekali contoh-contoh bagaimana membuat undangan, bagaimana menjawabnya. Nah, di sini dia cuma ngasih singkat mungkin, cuma sebagai introduction aja kepada teman-teman. Oke, sekarang kita lihat ke bawah. Nah, kita lanjut ke activity 3 ya. We continue to activity 3. Read and study these dialogues. Then act them out with your friends. Nah, ini dia. Ini kesukaan saya nih. Karena nanti dia banyak orang yang ngomong ini. Who wants to read dialogue 1? There are Ira and Ari. Ayo, siapa yang mau baca? Ini ada Ira, ada Ari nih. Ira Ari, Ira Ari. Oke, Ani. Oke, Lia, Ani dan Tia. Oke, yang paling cepat ya. Iya kan? Iya, Ani dan Tia. Oke, saya buka dulu ya. Tia dan Ani. Sebentar ya, teman-teman. Oke, Lia. Halo. Ini Tia ya? Ada. Saya udah dengar. Cuman ini Ani lagi. Ah, udah masuk nih. Halo. Oke. Ani Tia, udah bisa dengar? Oke, Ani. And where is Tia? Oh, halo. Oke. Oke, good. Can we start? Okay, so Ani will be Ira. Ani will be Ira and Tia will be Ari. Okay, start. Are you still busy? Bukan. Oke, continue. Sampai mana nih tadi? Coba tadi iranya kan, I guess not. Ayo, Ira. Ya. Okay, thank you. I will turn off your mic. Okay, so our friends Tia and Ani had already read the dialogue. Okay, we will discuss it one by one. Hello, hi Ira, this is Ari. Hello, halo Ira, this is Ari. Hi, how have you been? Apa kabar? Alright, thanks. Say, would you like to go out tonight? Baik-baik saja, terima kasih. Mau keluar nggak malam ini? Sorry, I can't. I have many matters to settle down. Maaf, saya tidak bisa. Saya banyak urusan untuk ditangani. Well, how about tomorrow night? Are you still busy? Kalau besok malam gimana? Masih sibuk nggak? I guess not. Saya rasa tidak. Well, would you like to go to a concert? Mau pergi ke konser nggak? Konser. Mau pergi ke konser enggak? Sure, I'd love to. Tentu saja. That's settled then. Okay. Nah, this dialogue is a type of dialogue that contains some invitation and also some answer that we have learned before. Nah, di dialog ini ada beberapa kalimat dia yang menyatakan invitation dan ada menyatakan jawaban. Seperti yang sudah kita pelajari tadi di halaman 58 yang pertama kali bubble-bubble itu. Nah, I want you to decide to give me one sentence contains of invitation. Saya mau teman-teman satu orang memberikan saya satu kalimat dari dialog ini yang dia bercerita tentang menginvite seseorang, mengundang seseorang. Ayo, satu aja. Ayo, apa itu dia? One sentence contains invitation from this dialogue. Udah ya? Ada yang ngetik ya? Oh, enggak. Come on, someone. From this 16 people, there must be somebody who can answer. Ayo teman-teman, one invitation sentence, satu jenis kalimat undangan. Oke. Saya sudah, kan miss lagi, ini salah ini, nggak nengok ke bawah ini, aduh, maaf ya. Ada Ani tadi yang pertama ya. Well, would you like to go to a concert? Okay, good job. There is an invitation sentence. Ada lagi dia yang lain. Coba Miss lihat ke bawah. Rofi tadi juga menjawab yang sama seperti kayak Ani, cuman kurang cepat. Oke. Ada Wiwin juga yang sama. Kenapa sama semua? Rasa suaranya putus-putus ya? Ara juga sama. Ada Dijua nih. Hi team, how are you when you have a free... Itu yang mana ya? Kan kita bicarain yang dialog satu. Oke, tadi yang pertama jawab berarti ada Ani, ya. Well, would you like to go to a concert? It is one type of invitation. So, I will tell you that this dialogue has how many invitation? I will count them now. First, like Annie said, would you like to go to concert? And then the second one is we can see it from the top. Okay, I can see it. And then the third sentence. Okay, so this sentence has three invitation sentence. Okay, Annie has mentioned one of them. Well, would you like to go to a concert? And then what is the second sentence? The second invitation sentence. Tadi kan Ani tadi sudah bilang, would you like to go to a concert sebagai tanya undangan, sebagai undangan invitation. Nah, saya lihat di dialog ini ada tiga kalimat yang menyatakan invitation, menyatakan undangan. Apalagi dua lagi, ayo. Ini tadi ada sazanya. Would you like to go out tonight? Okay, ya. Betul, ya. Itu juga sebagai salah satu undangan. Invitation. Satu lagi nih. Satu lagi. Pernyataan. Bukan pernyataan. Kalimat undangan. Okay, Ani lagi. Well, how about tomorrow night? Are you still busy? Iya, itu tadi jenis. There are three types, three sentences that contains invitation. First, we can see from the top, there is Ari. Would you like to go out tonight? And then the second one, that is from Ari to, well, how about tomorrow night? Are you still busy? Okay, and then the third one is also from Ari. Well, would you like to go to a concert? This was we are still on the first dialogue. Okay. Okay. As I have mentioned before to you that there are three sentences, three invitation sentences of this dialogue one. So how about the answer? Bagaimana jawabannya? How many sentences? Let me count. 1, 2, 3. They are also three answers of invitation. Nah, tadi kan kita udah jawab undangan. Kalimat undangan ada tiga di dialog ini. Nah, jawaban dari undangan itu juga ada tiga. What are they? Apa saja? Come on, the first. What is the answer of the invitation? Sorry, I can't. I have many matter to settle down. Right, benar sekali. Ani, sudah benar? Rofi? Sure, I'd love to. Okay, good job. Rofi. Ani and Rofi. The last sentence. Ayo. Satu lagi nih, kalimat jawaban undangannya. Selain yang sudah disebutkan oleh Ani dan Rofi. Nana? I guess not. Okay, that's it. That's all. Okay, Nana, get the first. Nana, answer faster than this one. Okay, jadi, there are three invitation sentences and also three answers of the invitation. First, invitation. Would you like to go out tonight? And then the answer, sorry, I can't. I have many matters to settle down. The second invitation, well, how about tomorrow night? Are you still busy? And then the answer, I guess not. And then the third invitation, well, would you like to go to a concert? Sure, I'd love to. Okay, so if we have learned about the example of the invitations before, in the first page, in the first part of speaking, and then now we learn how to put those sentences in a dialogue. Tadi kan kita belajar contoh-contoh undangannya. Bagaimana caranya? Nah, di sini kita belajar bagaimana cara memasukkan kalimat itu ke dialog. Okay, because we have two dialogue here, and then we will continue to dialogue two. Robbie invites Sandra to go to a movie. Who wants to be Robbie? Who wants to be Sandra? Come on. We win. Okay, we win jadi Sandra. Who else? Okay, this is Robbie. Wait a minute. I will turn on your microphone. This is and we win. Bentar ya. Dizua and Wiwin. Wiwin. Okay, halo. Halo, halo Dizua, halo Wiwin. Okay, can we start? Okay, we can start now. Okay, from Robbie. Okay, thank you Wiwin, thank you Dizua. Okay. Sudah mati kan ya? Okay. Nah, Robby invites Sandra to go to a movie. Hi Sandra, there will be a great film tonight. It's about Nasreddin. Would you like to go to the movie with me? Of course, I'd love to. When will you pick me up? I'll pick you up at 7:30. Be ready. Okay. Okay. Where is the invitation sentence in this dialogue? What is the invitation sentence of this dialogue? What is it? Come on, there is only one invitation and one answer. Okay, siapa cepat dia dapat? Siapa ini? Wiwin, would you like to go to the movie with me? Okay, very good. Clever. This is the type of invitation. Ya, telat Ani sama Rofi. And what is the answer? Come on. Yes. What is the answer? I'd love to. Of course. Only of course. Of course I'd love to. Nah, Wiwin ini setengah-setengah ini jawabnya ini. Of course pop dia. Kurang I'd love to-nya. Wiwin sama Ani ini sambil ya. Okay, Wiwin sama tadi invitation-nya ada Wiwin, tadi terus jawabannya ada Wiwin sama Ani. Oh, belum selesai kirim. Oh, oke lah, nggak apalah. Animis masukin juga. Alright, so we have one invitation and one answer here. What is the invitation? Would you like to go to the movie with me? And then the answer, of course, I love to. There has to be one full sentence. Jadi dia nggak boleh setengah-setengah, jangan of course saja. Harus dia, of course I love to. Nah, jadi Miss, when will you pick me up-nya? Itu juga jawaban Miss. Dia juga jawaban, tapi bukan termasuk dari jawaban yang seharusnya untuk menjawab invitation tadi. Ini sudah merupakan kalimat pertanyaan baru yang dilontarkan sama si Sandra. Jadi cukup dengan of course, I'd love to. Of course, I'd love to. Okay. Alright. So, we will... Okay, so, we already read about these two dialogues about how to invite someone and how to answer the invitation. Okay. So, we will continue to the next part. Activity 4, read and practice another dialogue, then identify the expressions of making an appointment. Okay, another dialogue. Ini suka kali nih dialogue ini. Read and practice another dialogue, then identify the expressions of making an appointment. Mrs. Lita Sugiarto, ini kayak nama penyanyi nih. Lita Sugiarto wants to get more information about the program at the smoking clinic. She calls the clinic to make an appointment. Jadi, si nyonya Lita Sugiarto ini mau mendapatkan informasi tentang sebuah program di smoking clinic. Nah, nama kliniknya itu smoking clinic. Jadi, si nyonya tersebut menelpon kliniknya itu untuk membuat janji. Who wants to be the receptionist? Who wants to be Mrs. Sugiarto? Come on. Okay, visual. Oh. Ani. Visual. Ani visual tadi udah belum ya? Udah kan ya? Miss kasih kesempatan sama yang lain gak apa-apa ya? Profi. Iya, Ani sama Bizua tadi kan udah Miss kasih kesempatan yang lain ya. Di sini ada Rofi sama Sukamti. Oke. Rofi dan Sukamti. Rofi will be as receptionist and Sukamti as Mrs. Sugiarto. Wait a minute. Rofi and Sukamti. Oke. Halo. Oke, halo, halo. Alright, we can start. Yes, of course. Yes, we can get ready now. Come on. Iya, ayo dimulai aja lagi dari awal ya. Suaranya kecil banget ya. Coba agak dibesarin teman-teman. Iya, agak dibesarin. Coba teman-temannya nggak denger nih yang lain. Oke, got it, got it. Oke, continue. Okay, receptionist, how about tomorrow? Nine PM. Okay. Rofinya belum selesai baca ini. Iya. Oke, let's go, Rofi. Iya, PM. Okay, thank you, Rofi. Thank you. Okay, saya matikan ya. Thank you, Sukanti. Alright, so our friends, Rofi and Sukanti, has read about the dialogue about how to make an appointment. Tadi suaranya kekecilan ya, nggak apa-apa ya. I will read it once again. Smoking clinic, can I help you? Yes, I need further information about your quitting smoking program in the smoking clinic. The clinic will gladly inform you about the program, but you have to come to the clinic. Alright, when should I come? How about tomorrow at 9 PM? Dr. Ali Wardana will be available for consultation about the program. I'll be there. Can I have your name, please? Lita Sugiarto. LITA. Alright, Mrs. Lina Sugiarto. Ini saya heran ini. Katanya Lita kok jadi Lina ini. Salah ketik nih kayaknya. Alright, Miss Lina Sugiarto. You'll meet Dr. Ali Wardana tomorrow at 9 PM. Thank you. Bye. You're welcome. Bye. Okay, so this is... This has not anything related to our lesson, the invitation and the answer. This dialogue just to show you how to make an appointment. Ini teman-teman semua ngerti artinya ini kan? Apa perlu saya artikan lagi atau gimana ini dialognya? Or we should continue to the next part, or I just give you the meaning of this dialogue. Oke, artikan juga boleh, Miss. Oh, oke. Alright. Smoking clinic, can I help you? Smoking clinic, ada yang bisa saya bantu? Yes, I need further information saya butuh informasi lengkap about your quitting smoking program in the smoking clinic, tentang program bagaimana sih cara berhenti merokok di smoking clinic. Nah, datang si resepsionisnya. The clinic will gladly inform you about the program. Klinik kami akan dengan senang menginformasikan tentang program ini. But you have to come to the clinic. Tapi kamu harus datang ke klinik. Alright, when shall I come? Okay, kapan saya harus datang? How about tomorrow at 9 p.m? Bagaimana kalau besok jam 9 malam? Dr. Ali Wardana will be available for consultation about the program. Dr. Ali Wardana akan ada untuk konsultasi tentang program ini. I'll be there. Aku akan datang. Aku akan di sana. Can I have your name, please? Tolong nama Anda? Lita Sugiarto, L-I-T-A. Alright, Mrs. Lina Sugiarto, you'll meet Dr. Ali Wardana tomorrow at 9 p.m. Okay, Miss Lina Sugiarto, kamu akan, Anda akan menemui Dr. Ali Wardana besok jam 9 malam. Thank you, bye, you're welcome, bye. Okay, is there any questions so far? Ada pertanyaan sejauh ini? Ada pertanyaan sejauh ini? If there is no question, we can continue to the next part. Quitting itu berhenti. Jadi kalau quitting smoking itu berhenti merokok. Quitting smoking program, program untuk berhenti merokok. Bisa diulang? Oh, bisa. Bagian mananya nih? We can move next page. Kata dasar yang, kata dasarnya itu quit. Sebenarnya ada, Miss. Tapi bingung mau tanya yang mana loh. Jadi gimana kalau saya? Ini jajannya mau diulang bagian mana? Which part should I replace? Which part sajanya? Don't tell me if you need to repeat the whole sentence. Come on, sajanya. Oh, mau catat yang belum tahu kata-katanya. Okay, once again ya, I will tell you the meaning of the each sentence once again. Just tell me whenever you need to stop, so I can stop and you can write the meaning. Okay. Smoking clinic, can I help you? Smoking clinic? Ada yang bisa saya bantu? Yes, I need further information. Saya butuh informasi lebih lengkap about your quitting smoking program in the smoking clinic. Tentang program bagaimana cara berhenti merokok di smoking clinic. The clinic will gladly inform you. Klinik kami akan dengan senang memberitahukan Anda about the program, tentang program tersebut. But you have to come to the clinic. Tapi kamu harus datang ke kliniknya. Alright, when should I come? Okay, kapan saya harus datang? How about tomorrow at 9 p.m? Bagaimana kalau besok jam 9 malam? Dr. Ali Wardana will be available for consultation about the program. Dr. Ali Wardana akan dengan senang bukan dengan senang, Dokter Ali Wardana akan ada untuk konsultasi tentang program tersebut. I'll be there, aku akan di sana. Can I have your name, please? Tolong nama Anda? Lita Sugiarto, LITA. Alright, this is Lina Sugiarto. You'll meet Dr. Ali Wardana tomorrow at 9 p.m. Anda akan berjumpa dengan Dr. Ali Wardana besok jam 9 malam. Thank you, bye. You're welcome, bye. Okay, so if there is any of you who still didn't get the meaning, who still don't understand what am I saying about, you can ask me privately by chat me on Facebook, okay? So we will not waste our time to just repeat the meaning of the sentence in this session, okay? Jadi kalau misalnya teman-teman ada yang agak kurang jelas atau ada yang tidak mengerti atau paham artinya, bisa tanya saya di Facebook aja ya, chatnya aja. Mungkin kita bisa, kita akan buang-buang waktu juga kalau terlalu lama di sini mengulang-ulang. Okay, we will continue to the next one. What to say? Study the following expressions of inviting, accepting, declining an invitation and appointment. Pelajari kalimat-kalimat berikut tentang inviting. Inviting adalah mengundang. Accepting, menerima. Declining, menolak. An invitation and an appointment. Undangan dan perjanjian. Jadi di sini, ini yang tabel-tabel ini, we will learn how to invite, accept, and decline an invitation and an appointment. And the table is divided into two parts. There are formal situation and informal situation. So we will see the first table. Kita akan lihat dulu ya yang tabel pertamanya. There are three rows. Di situ ada tiga kolom. Inviting, accepting an invitation, and declining an invitation. Yang pertama, mengundang. Bagaimana cara mengundang? Yang di tengah ada bagaimana cara menerima undangan? Dan yang ketiga, bagaimana cara menolak undangan? Nah, who wants to read inviting part? Siapa dia yang mau baca ini invitingnya? Inviting talk ya, yang lainnya nanti nggak kebagian. Ani lagi dia, oke Ani tapi udah juga nih, Sukanti udah juga. Ara. Okay, we will give the change to our friends, okay? Ara. Ara, 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 Ara. Okay, this one. Okay, Ara, you can start. Hello, good evening. Okay, yeah. Yeah, right. Okay, thank you, Ara. Okay, so, inviting. Would you like to? I'd very much like you to. We should be pleased or delighted if you could. Would you care to? You will, won't you? Nah, jadi ini dia. So, this is how we invite someone. So as you can see that this sentence is just a half sentence. Jadi kita bisa lihat ini kan cuma setengah. Jadi ini itu titik-titiknya nanti diisi apa? Okay, so we will give an example. Would you like to come to my birthday party? Would you like to come to my birthday party? Maukah kamu datang ke pesta ulang tahun saya. Nah, would you like to come to my birthday party? Come to my birthday party-nya ini, you can replace it with any sentence. So I will give you the example, okay? Would you like to? Where is the text? Okay, this one. Would you like to? Nah, seperti yang saya, as I mentioned to you before, we can fill the full stop, this half sentence, with anything that we would we want to invite. For example, would you like to come to my birthday party? Would you like to come? Another example. Would you like to come to? Not come. We will use another verb. Kita pakai verb yang lain ya. Would you like to? Okay. Would you like to date with me on weekend? Oh, this is a nice example. I like it so much. Would you like to date with me on weekend? Wah, saya suka sekali nih contohnya ini. Would you like to date with me on weekend? Maukah kamu pergi kencan denganku weekend ini? Is there any another example? I want you to give me another example. Would you like to what? Would you like to what? Like to come on, another example. To have a cup of coffee. Yes. Would you like to have a cup of coffee? To have a cup of coffee with me. Nah, okay, good job. So come this one. Would you like to dinner with me Sunday night? Okay, I will fix your sentence. Would you like to dinner with me Sunday night? Nah, this is the sentence that your friend Sijua has typed. Would you like to dinner with me Sunday night? This is a good example, but not a really 100% true. Contoh yang bagus, cuman dia grammarnya salah. Nah, jadi Miss, gimana yang betul? Would you like to have a dinner with me? Apa? Ayo. Apa yang kurang nih? Would you like to have a dinner with me on Sunday night? Nah, itu dia. Ayo kita lihat lagi apa ada dikasih lagi contohnya sama yang lain. Come to dinner with me. Oke, Rofi dia hampir-hampir sama. Contohnya kayak kayak siapa tadi? Kayak Dizua. Oke, ini Dizua lagi. Would you like to come and join with me on my meeting with my friends? Wow, this is a really good example. Oke, the last example, we will move to the next part. Would you like to come and join with me on my meeting with my friend? Oh, again, there is a mistake in the sentence. Would you like to come and join with me on my meeting with my friend? Oh. Ayo, apa kesalahannya coba? Bukan friend school. Apa misalnya? School friends. Dibalik-balik dia. Okay, would you like to come and join me on my meeting with my friends? Nah, that's so. This is the example of sentences that we can fill in this blank. Jadi yang di titik-titik ini kita bisa isi dengan ini. Come to my birthday party, date with me on weekend, have a cup of coffee with me, have a dinner with me on Sunday night, come and join with me on my meeting with my school friends. Okay? Okay, we will move to the next part. Nah, this is the next example. I very much like you too. I di sini artinya I would, ya. Artinya I would. The missing susah kali nih, nggak ada mouse jadinya. Maaf ya teman-teman, agak lama nih nulis. I itu sama dengan I would, atau bisa juga dia I had, tergantung dari konteks kalimatnya. Alright, so I would very much like you too. I would very much like you too. I would very much like you. Kata di katanya, I would very much like you too. As you can see that this is also only a half sentences. This blank space you can fill with the same pattern like this one. So for example, I very much like you to come to my birthday party. This is not a question. I'm pretty sure that they shouldn't put the question here. Yeah. Ini jangan ada kalimat tanya ya, nanti dia ambigu dia jadi artinya. Nah, jadi contohnya gini. So the example will be like this. I'd very much like you to come to my birthday party. Full stop, not a question mark. I'd very much like you to date with me on weekend. I'd very much like you to have a cup of coffee with me. I'd very much like you to have a dinner with me on Sunday night. I'd very much like you to come and join with me on my meeting with my school friends. Nah, so this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 patterns, 5 example of invitation, we can put it here on this blank space. You can choose whatever you want. If you want to invite someone, you can use this. You will come to my birthday party, won't you? You can use this. We should be pleased or delighted if you could come to my birthday party. And you can use whatever you like. Alright, so that is the inviting part. And then we continue to accept the invitation. Jadi kalau misalnya udah ada orang yang undang, kita gimana mau nerimanya? Gimana mau menolaknya? Nah, the second row is how to accept an invitation. Who wants to read? Who wants to read this example? Come on everyone, who wants to read this example? I hope the person who show up is another person, not like Ani, Bijua, Rosi, Susanti. Come on, somebody please, somebody else except them, ya. Susanti nggak bisa dengar. Ayo, siapa yang mau baca ini di accepting an invitation-nya? Ani udah, dijual juga udah sering. Wiwin, nah ini dia, Wiwin. Okay, I will turn on your microphone. Wiwin, gimana ya? Oh ini dia. Wiwin. Oh, Wiwin juga udah. Wiwin udah, Win. Kok saya yang jadi lupa ini? Oh, just a little. Oke, nggak apa-apa, Wiwin. Wiwin kali ini ya. Oke, come on, Win. Oh, jajannya nanti. Jajannya nanti yang declining ya. Halo, Wiwin. Alright, you can start how to accept an invitation. Okay, thank you, Vivian. Okay, so Vivian has read the sentence that show us about how to accept an invitation. First example, that's very kind of you. We'd very much like to. What a delightful idea. With the greatest pleasure. Thank you very much for inviting me. Okay, so if someone invites you, so for example, I invite you all to come to my birthday party, and I will say to you, would you like to come to my birthday party? And then you can say, that's very kind of you, or you can say, we'd very much like to. Nah, di sini kok ada blank space-nya lagi nih, Miss Isi, apa ini? Nah, yang isinya ini tadi bisa diisi ke kembali yang ini dia tadi. Nah, contoh-contohnya ini. Nah, kan, I ask you, would you like to come to my birthday party? So, you can say, we would very much like to come to your birthday party. Or you can just simply say, what a delightful idea with the greatest pleasure. Thank you very much for inviting me. So, you can use these sentences to accept an invitation, whatever you like, whatever you want. Alright? Okay, the next part is declining an invitation. That is cajanya. Halo, cajanya. Hello, you can start how to decline an invitation. Okay, thank you, Cezinha. Okay, how to decline an invitation? I am very sorry, I don't think I can. I'd like to, but I'm afraid I've already promised. Thank you for asking me, but unfortunately, I can't. Nah, you can decline the invitation of somebody by simply saying this sentence. So for example, like the first example, I invite you to my birthday party. Would you like to come to my birthday party? But you cannot attend my birthday party because you have something else to do. So, politely, dengan sopan, you can decline. Kamu bisa menolak ajakan saya. Gimana caranya, Miss? Right after I say my invitation, would you like to come to my birthday party? And you can say, I am very sorry. I don't think I can. Saya minta maaf. Sepertinya saya tidak bisa. Nah, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sentences, that is the type of sentence you can say how to decline an invitation. Nah, Miss, kok jadi ada bolong-bolongnya lagi nih? Apa sama ada isi? Bukan. Ini isinya beda. This blank space can be filled with reason. With reason, ya. How to decline. Decline invitation. Decline invitation. Jadi ini misalnya nih, Mei Chung Jang nih kan. Would you like to come my birthday party. Okay. I will put the first example here. I am very sorry, I don't think I can. This is the simple answer. So how about the complicated one? Jadi gimana yang kalau rumit, yang ada blank space-nya, yang ada titik-titiknya? I'd like to, but I'd like to, but okay, Sukanti. I like to put. Nah, jadi ini sini diisi apa nih? Gak boleh sama yang kayak pattern yang di atas. We cannot copy this pattern to this one because this is a really different sentences. Coba kita artikan dulu sama-sama ya. Would you like to come to my birthday party? Apakah kamu mau datang ke pesta ulang tahun saya? I am very sorry, I don't think I can. Saya minta maaf, kayaknya saya nggak yakin saya bisa. I'd like to, but sebenarnya saya mau. Tapi, nah, this is, we can fill it with reason. I saw this one has already mentioned one reason. I will write it here. I'd like to, but unfortunately, this is this one sentence. Unfortunately, salah nulisnya. Unfortunately, I promise to meet my uncle. I have a promise to meet my uncle. Aduh, saya sebenarnya mau, tapi kayaknya saya nggak bisa, soalnya saya ada janji untuk bertemu dengan paman saya. Nah, it is one example of a reason. Come on, another example. I'd like to, but who wants to give me another example? Reason. Misalnya nih, misalnya bahasa Indonesia-nya ya. Saya mau, tapi saya ada kelas. Saya mau, tapi Naisha, I have class today. Good job. But I have class today. Okay. Yang lain. I'd like to, but apa lagi contohnya nih? I am your class music. Ini Ani maksudnya apa ini? I am your class music. I am your class music. Tak ngerti miss ini. Dijual. I'm not sure come. I had care Rahmah in hospital. Oh, ngerti miss. Pakai visual dulu ya. But I coba misalnya dulu kalimatnya head care Rahma in hospital. Ini maksudnya pasti saya harus menjaga Rahma di rumah sakit, ya kan? Nah, contoh kalimatnya bukan seperti ini. We should fix it, but I have to take care of Rahma in hospital. Ya, saya harus menjaga Rahma di rumah sakit. Oke? Full stop. No, not it full stop. Kemudian ada Wiwin. I have to finish my homework. Ya, bisa juga. Bisa sekali. I'd like to, but I have to finish my homework. example, I note kan depannya, Miss. Coba contoh terakhir dari Ani nih ya, yang tadi ya, I not can. But I masih nggak ngerti nih saya nih. Nah, terakhir. The last example from Ara. I have to go dinner with my family. Okay. I'd like to, but I have to go dinner with my family. Good job, Ara. Okay. So, this is the pattern of how to decline the invitation. As we can see here, this blank space you can fill with the pattern of sentence from here. Jangan terbalik ya, jangan pula nanti yang titik-titik di sini diisi ke yang sini. Nah, amburadul dia jadinya. This blank space, for example, I'm afraid I have already promised to go dinner with my family. I'm afraid I already have promised to finish my homework. Okay. So this is how to invite, how to accept, and how to decline. Nah, I want to ask you something. This class has begun at 9 p.m. Right? Tadi kan kelasnya mulai jam 9. But unfortunately, some of you didn't show up, so I have to wait until about 30 minutes. Tapi tadi kalian tidak ada yang muncul jam 9 tepat. Bagaimana kalau saya extend? Bisa di-extend atau tidak ini? Nah, sudah saya extend jadinya sampai 10 menit ke depan. Cuman, like I said that we have to finish 2 hours. Actually, we have to finish the class for 2 hours. But this is only 1 and 30 minutes. 1 hour and 30 minutes. Kita cuma 1 jam 30 menit. Kalau saya lanjutkan 30 menit lagi, bisa atau tidak? Bagaimana nih teman-teman? Okay, what is my name? Oh, I forgot to tell you my name. My name is Elma. E-L-M-A. Okay, we win. It's okay. Thank you. Okay, so we all agree to continue 30 minutes later. Okay, kita setuju kan? Udah 30 menit extend kan? Nah, tadi saya sudah ketik 10 menit extend, berarti kita masih punya utang 20 menit extend. Okay, so we have to continue fast. I want to finish this class by finish to read this table. Okay, so as I mentioned to you before, it's okay, Dizua, you can leave whenever you want. This is formal situation and this is informal situation. So just now we already mentioned you about the formal situation. So right now I want you to read about the informal situation. Apa bedanya Miss formal situation sama informal situation? Nah, kalau formal itu yang resmi. Kalau yang informal ini yang secara tidak resmi. So I can simply say that if you want to invite someone who is older than me, or at least has the same age with me, we have to use the formal. But if we want to invite someone who is younger than me, or my best friend, or my classmate, I can just simply use the informal. Jadi kalau misalnya ada orang yang lebih tua nih, ada orang yang lebih tua kita undang. atau kita mau undang bos kita, majikan kita, atau orang yang lebih tinggi jabatannya di atas kita. Nah, kita bisa pakai yang formal situation. Tapi kalau misalnya kita mau mengundang yang di bawah kita umurnya, atau sebaya, atau teman dekat kita, atau keluarga dekat, adik, abang, atau gimana, kita bisa pakai yang informal. Sebenarnya, that is, they do not have a lot of difference. It's just they use the simple words. Jadi sebenarnya perbedaannya nggak banyak. Cuman yang di informal situation ini, mereka pakai kata-kata yang lebih singkat biar lebih langsung to the point ya. Kalau formal dia kan basa-basi ini. Kalau informal dia, mau pergi nggak? Nah, gitu dia. Okay, the same table, inviting, accepting an invitation, and declining an invitation. Who wants to read inviting part? Siapa yang mau baca yang inviting? Ayo. Ani, lagi. Yang lain dong. Kan ada 12 orang. I want to hear your voice. I have already heard any Dizwa, Rosi, Sukanti, Tia, Wiwin, Ara tadi, Vicky, I want you to turn on your microphone, where is Vicky? Okay. Kok lama sekali nih ya loadingnya. Why so long? Vicky, you there? It looks like Vicky or me has something trouble with the signal or the microphone, but I'm not sure I can turn off his or her microphone because still loading. How about charger-nya? But charger-nya has already read. I want somebody else. Come on. Annie, not you anymore. You already mentioned a lot. Naisha, okay, Naisha ya. Naisha, sebentar ya. Vicky sepertinya memang tidak bisa ini saya aktifkan atau bagaimana ini. Coba nanti coba lagi ya. Sekarang saya, I want you to turn on Naisha. Terlalu semangat, iya, bahasa itu terlalu semangat. Atau ini sepertinya internet saya tuh bagaimana ini? Kok Naisha juga tidak bisa? Tuh jadinya kita lama-lama di nunggu loading ini, duh. Coba Miss coba Ani ya. Apa karena tadi di extend jadinya ini Ani bisa? Halo Ani. Iya, bisa nih. Iya, berarti ini rezekinya Ani. Yuk, Ani, yuk. Iya. Oke. Oke, thank you, Ani. Si Ani nampaknya ini semangat ini. Tapi saya juga, I'm still confused why Vico and Nasha cannot, I cannot turn on their microphone. What happened? And it's somebody else. Susah sinyal ya? Okay. Inviting. This is the informal situation, alright? Why don't you come to why don't you come to my birthday party? Kenapa nggak datang ke pesta ulang tahun aku? Like to come to, come in, shall we come to, you must come to, you must come to my birthday party, shall we come to my birthday party, come and join us, like to come to my birthday party. So you can use the same pattern. Iya, sinyalnya nih. We can use the same pattern for this. With this pattern. Okay? Okay. Jadi, kita bisa lihat di sini ya. Kita bisa lihat di sini. Yang di for. From formal situation and informal situation, you can see this blank space here. Nah, you can use the same pattern for both of them. From here. And how about the accepting invitation? Who wants to read the part? Who wants to read this part? How to accept an invitation? Maybe I should combine it with decline an invitation because we do not have much time. So one person will read these two parts. Okay, come on. Somebody please. Ara ya. Not any. Not again. Halo Ara. Yeah, you can read accepting an invitation and declining an invitation. Ya, halo. Iya, dua ya, yang ini sama ini. Yes. Accepting, declining. Yes. Yeah, you can start, Ara. Yeah, hello. Bisa dimulai. Ayo. Ya, right. Arah. Oke. We read the informal. Ya, oke, nggak apa-apa, ya. Oke, thank you, Ara. Oke, so this is how to accept and how to decline an invitation from informal situation. For example, I will come to your party. That will be very nice. Okay, Alex, I'd like to love to come. All right then. And how to decline? Sorry, I can't. I love to, but I don't think I can. I wish I could, but you can see from here that this formal situation has more words in one sentence. But for informal situation, they use the really simple words like this. Okay, alright. Nah, jadi kalau misalnya informal ini cuma pendek-pendek aja dia kata-katanya, nggak apa-apa karena dia tidak resmi. Tapi kalau yang di formal memakai kata-kata sopan, memakai kata-kata yang lebih resmi dibanding yang tidak resmi. Okay. And we move on to how to make an appointment. I only need one person for these three parts. Making an appointment, accepting an appointment, and canceling an appointment. Nah, jadi saya mau satu orang baca. I want one of you read these three parts. Satu orang baca sekaligus tiga. Tiga kolom. Ayo, siapa mau? The last change of this session. Kesempatan terakhir dari sesi ini. Ara, not again. Jangan lagi ya. Give the change. Rofi. Rofi. Let's try Rofi. Rofi. Oke. Okay. Halo Rofi, you can start whenever you ready. Okay, thank you, Rofi. Okay, so we already learned how to make an invitation, how to accept invitation, how to decline invitation by formal and informal situation. And this last table, this is the part when we learn how to make an appointment. Kita di sini, yang di table ini, kita belajar bagaimana cara membuat janji pertemuan, accepting an appointment, menerima janji ataupun membatalkannya, canceling. Contohnya, example, how about tomorrow morning? Let's meet at 9 o'clock. And how to accept? I will come, I promise. I'll be there. And how to cancel? Sorry, I don't think I can make it. I'm so sorry, I can make it. Okay, so for this part, I want to give you an example. tadi making an appointment. How about tomorrow morning? Let's meet at a club. Blah blah blah. Respect. Okay. Making an appointment. Contohnya tadi. Let's meet tomorrow night. I want to use us as the example. Saya mau menggunakan kita sebagai contoh. We have class this. We have class tonight, right? So, a few days ago, I will ask you whether we can have class tonight or not. So, I will write here, Elma. Let's meet. Let's have class. Jadi, saya mau buat janji dengan kalian. Let's night jadinya. Let's have class. Let's have a class tomorrow night. We can start at 9 PM. Kita biasanya mulai jam 9 kan? Okay, jadi saya ngomong nih. Let's have a class tomorrow night. We can start at 9 PM. And then you said, for example, Ani, dia bilang, dia bisa. Nah, dia, she wants to accept my appointment. So this is how to use it. I'll come, I promise, I'll be there. Ani, dia bilang jadinya, karena dia bisa nih, dia bilang, I'll come. I promise. Terus, ada lagi nih yang datang yang lain. Contohnya, si siapa ya? Rasa. Rasa bisa juga datang. Jadi dia pakai contoh kalimat yang kedua. I'll be there. I'll be there. Nah, kan cuma dua orang nih yang jawab. Because there is only two people who answer my question, I will ask you once again. How about the others? Mana nih yang lain? Nah, muncul lagi nih yang lain. Misalnya tadi Wiwin. Nah, Wiwin nggak bisa, harus jaga Akong. Nah, misalnya dia nggak bisa nih harus jaga Akong karena Wiwin nggak bisa. So she used the sentence how to cancel an appointment. Sorry, I don't think I can make it. Dia. Sorry, I don't think I can make it. And here comes another person. For example, Ara. Ara juga nggak bisa nih, Miss. Jadi pakai yang mana? Nah, pakai yang kedua. I'm so sorry, I can't make it. I'm so sorry. Wiwin and Ara has already said to me that they cannot attend the class. Jadi Wiwin sama Sarah udah bilang sama saya, misalnya nggak bisa datang. But why? Tapi kenapa? They didn't mention the reason. Mereka nggak bilang alasannya. Nah, if we want to cancel an appointment, it is up to us whether we want to give they the reason or not. Jadi kalau misalnya kita mau batalin janji nih, nggak bisa nih. Gak bisa datang nih, Miss. Nah, tapi kita gak mau ngasih tahu alasannya. Gak apa-apa. Tapi kalau mau ngasih tahu alasannya itu lebih bagus lagi. Lebih sopan lagi. So, for example, we want to give a reason for we win. Sorry, Miss. Gak bisa. Sorry. I don't think I can make it. I have to take care of Akong. Sorry, Miss. Gak bisa. Harus jaga Akong. Kemudian, and then... Ara comes. I'm so sorry, Miss. I can't make it. Ara mau ngapain dia ya? I have to cook dinner. I have to cook dinner tonight. Oh, tomorrow night. Karena kan diundangnya kan besok malam kan? Tomorrow night, for example. Jadi Aranya bilang, maaf nih, saya nggak bisa, soalnya saya harus masak makan malam besok malam. Nah, this is the kind of sentence that show us how to make an appointment, how to accepting an appointment. And this is how to canceling an appointment. Okay, so our class end this part. Jadi kelas kita akhirnya di sini ya, sampai dia making an appointment. We will continue next week or whenever I talk to your monitor, class monitor. Jadi kita lanjut kalau nggak minggu depan, atau nanti saya kapan kasih tahu ke ketua kelas masing-masing. If you have any question, just chat me by Facebook. If you want to chat me by Facebook, you have to add me first, because I will not see your message if we are not friends. Nah, jadi kalau misalnya mau chat saya, harus temenan dulu, karena nanti dia kan masuk ke folder yang ada. Saya jarang lihat folder itu, jadinya otomatis harus berteman dulu. Okay, so FB-nya bisa lihat di grup ya, atau kalau nggak tahu bisa tanya ketua kelas masing-masing. Okay, assalamualaikum.